Hi, hello and welcome to another session on data communications and networks. In today's session, we'll see the various physical topologies. So physical topology is the way in which a network is laid out physically. So when two or more devices, suppose you have a device one here and another device two, so both of these two devices are connected by using a link. This is the communication link. So two or more such links, we call it as a physical topology. So physical topology is the combination of the various communication links and the relationships of all links and devices. So we'll see the types of physical topologies. We have four types. We have the mesh topology, then we have the star topology, we have the bus topology, ring topology, and we have the hybrid topology. So these are the five types of topologies in data communications. So we'll see each of them in detail. So we'll see the first one, the mesh topology. So in the mesh topology, every device has a dedicated point-to-point link to every other device. You have a device one here and another device two. So every device is connected to every other device. Suppose we have another device D3, another device D4, and so on. So every device is connected to every other device. So D1 is connected to D2, D1 is also connected to D4. Similarly, D2 is connected to D1, D2 is also connected to D3, and D2 is also connected to D4. Similarly, D3 is also connected to D2, D1, and D4, and D4 is also connected to D1, D2, and D3. So every device, it has a dedicated link to every other device in the network. By this dedicated link, we mean that, so this is the dedicated link, means it is the link that carries traffic only between the two connecting devices. So this, we have a link here between D1 and D2. That is a dedicated link. We call it as a dedicated link. Why? Because this link is carrying the traffic. We call it, this is the message, or the traffic is carried only between D1 and D2. That's why we call it as a dedicated link. So to find the number of physical links in a mesh. In a mesh topology, we have a formula here. So this is equal to n into n minus 1, where n is the number of devices present in the network. They, we also call them as nodes. Number of nodes or number of devices. Okay. Suppose in the previous example we have seen, we have four devices D1, D2, D3 and D4. So in this case n is equal to 4. So number of the physical links is equal to 4 into 4 minus 1, that is 3. So we have 12 physical links when there are 4 devices. We'll see the other formula also. Now, if the link allows communication in both the directions, in both the directions means that is a duplex mode. So we have already seen what is a simplex, duplex, half full duplex, and half duplex mode. In the duplex mode, if you have two devices, D1 and D2, so there is a link between both of these two devices. So the D1 will be able to communicate with D2, as well as D2 also will be able to communicate with D1. So this is a duplex mode. So if the link is allowing communication in both the directions, then in this case, the number of physical links, we have another formula for this. This is equal to n into n minus 1 divided by 2. So these are the two formulas. In the earlier formula which we have seen, that is n into n minus 1. So this formula is applicable in the case where there is no communication in both the directions. There is communication only in a unidirection. Okay. So if there is bidirectional communication, we have to use this formula, n into n minus 1 by 2. So we'll see one example and we'll draw the mesh topology. We'll take one example here. N is equal to 5. Suppose there are 5 devices in the network. So the number of links, or the number of physical links in this case, is equal to 5 into 5 minus 1, that is 20. So we should get 20 links. So we'll draw that. Suppose this is the device D1, then we have the device D2, D3, D4 and D5. So all 5 devices are present. We'll check whether we are getting the same number of links by using these devices. Now we'll consider that there is communication only in one direction, that is unidirectional. So D1 should be connected to D2. D1 also should be connected to D3. From D1 to D4, D1 to D5. Now similarly, D2 also should be connected to D1. Just remember, we are using a unidirectional link. That's why we need to put another link from D2 to D1. Next, D2 to D3, D2 to D4, D2 to D5. Next, coming to D3. From D3 to D2, D3 to D1, D3 to D4, and D3 to D5. Now coming to D4, D4 to D3, D4 to D2, D4 to D1, and D4 to D5. Next coming to D5, D5 to D1, D5 to D2, D5 to D3, and finally D5 to D4. Now if you count the number of links here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19, 20. So 20 number of links we are getting. So in the by using the formula also, we got the same thing, n into n minus 1, that is 20 physical links. Now this is the case when there is communication in only one direction. So one link is used for communicating in one direction. Now we'll see the other formula where we have taken the duplex mode of communication. So if there is communication in both the directions on a single link, so in duplex mode, we'll use the same nodes again or devices, D1, D2, D3, D4 and D5. We'll use the duplex mode, that is communication in both the directions. So D1 should be connected to D2. D2 can also use the same link to communicate with D1. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are the links from D1 to D2, D1 to D3, D1 to D4 and D1 to D5. Next, we'll start with D2, D2 to D1. The same link can be used, D2 to D3, D2 to D4 and D2 to D5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Next, from D3 to D2, D3 to D1, D3 to D4, and finally D3 to D5. So 7 plus 2, that is 9. Next, from D4 to D3, D2, D1. All these three are present. Only thing missing is D4 to D5. So if you count the number of links here, we got the number of links as 10. So by using the formula also, we have n into n minus 1 by 2. So this is 5 into 4 divided by 2. So this is also equal to 10. So these are the two formulae which we use to find the number of physical links in a mesh topology. So we'll see what are the advantages and disadvantages of this mesh topology. You see the advantages. So we are using dedicated links here. So because of the use of dedicated links, so every connection, that means every link or every connection, it carries its own data. So this is the first advantage of mesh topology. So every link carries its own data or the message. Second advantage is there is no problem of traffic. That is, the traffic problems are not present, or you can write traffic problems are eliminated. Why? Because if you see one particular link between D1 and D2, so this link is used for messaging between D1 and D2. No other device can use the same link for transmitting data or messages. So only both the two devices will be able to communicate with each other on this particular link. So another advantage is the mesh topology is very robust. The connections and the links are very strong and reliable. Next advantage is even if one link is damaged, or if one link there is a problem with one link, the entire system is not affected. So if one link is damaged, so the entire system goes on as usual without any problem. Entire system is not affected. The next advantage is privacy and security. Privacy and security. So because D1 is transmitting a message to D2. So that message will be received only by D2, not by anyone else, because they are using dedicated links to transmit the message. So there is high privacy and security in the data transmission. The next advantage is identification of faults is very easy. So the fault identification is easy. That means if there is a problem with any one link, the traffic can be routed by other links. The next advantage is we can exactly know the location of the fault. That means precise location of the fault can be identified, or fault can be known. So these are some of the advantages of using this mesh topology. Next, we'll see the disadvantages. What are the disadvantages in this mesh topology? So as you can see, we are using this formula n into n minus 1 to find the number of physical links. So if there are 5 devices in the network, we need 20 such links. So because of this, many cables and more number of input outputs are required. That means many physical links or cables are required. Along with this, the IO ports are also required. Many cables and input output ports are required. The second disadvantage is the installation is difficult. The next one is the wiring or the cabling is very bulky because there are many cables present here. The next disadvantage is the hardware which is required is expensive. These are all the advantages and disadvantages of the mesh topology. So we'll see one application of this mesh topology. So mesh topology can be used in the telephone regional offices. So suppose there is a regional office at this particular point. This regional office has to be connected to the next immediate regional office, and another regional office also it has to be connected. So R1 has to be connected to R2 and R3. Similarly, R2 also has to be connected to R1 and R3, and R3 also has to be connected to R2 and R1. So this is one of the application of this mesh topology. It is used to link all the telephone regional offices together. So this is the mesh topology. In the next session, we'll see the star topology and other types of topologies. That's all in this session. I hope I am clear. Thank you.